In this tutorial, I'll explain you how to use a Canon DSLR to capture 14-bit RAW footage. First of all, the RAW feature is not fully implemented, and unless you have a 5D Mark III, it is not possible to shoot RAW in all resolutions. But even if you shoot RAW on a smaller resolution, you get more sharpness and detail in your picture than the standard Canon 1080p footage. The most Canon DSLR cameras should be able to have Magic Lantern and the RAW feature. You can visit the Magic Lantern homepage and check out your camera support. If you don't have Magic Lantern, you can grab it there. All necessary links are posted in the description. Once you have Magic Lantern installed, you might need the RAW Rack module. The module should be implemented, but if you don't find it, you can download the module directly from the Nightly Builds. You also need a good SD card to record the RAW footage. I have a Transcat SDHC level 10 card for my 550D. The only important thing is that your card uses the full write speed of your camera. If you don't know your card write speed, you can search for benchmarks on the internet. I have a simple list for you to find the write speed of your camera. I will link an even better list in the description. Now let's get some footage. Ensure you shoot in 1080p mode. Load up the RAW module and set your FPS override to your desired frame rate. I use 24 FPS to keep the write buffer of the camera small. Then enable the RAW module, set your resolution and ratio, and you are ready to go. I've done several recordings, one of them should be fine. It is not simply possible to import your recorded footage directly to After Effects. Therefore, I use a tool from the Magic Lantern forums called RAW2DNG. This program allows you to simply drag your files on the executable, and this file will convert your RAW file to a readable DNG sequence. You don't have to do anything beside that. Maybe I should write a guide like the Online Arts HDR guide for being able to mass convert your files. Post this in the comments. Import your image sequence to a new composition. After Effects will open up a simple RAW editor where you can perform your first color correction, but most of the time your footage will already look good. Click OK to exit and you have 14-bit footage in your composition. I use mainly two effects for the post-production. The Magic Bullet Instant HD plugin will upscale your cropped image to 1080p. Yes, this step is a digital upscale. But the QuickTime format on the standard Canon cameras is actually a digital downscale, so you will definitely get more detail and colors even with an upscaled image. The second effect is Knit Video. This plugin can help you to remove the grain coming from your sensor. It's very effective. You can build your own grain profile or just create an automated profile. I see I have to switch the effects for proper visualization, but this looks pretty good now. Let's render a warm and a cold version of it. you have any questions about this tutorial, post it down below. If you like this tutorial, please subscribe.